Hi there. My name is Dimitris Haralabidis, and in this video, we are going to see how we can find the trigonometric ratios of 180 and 270 degrees, and all that by using the unit circle. Before we proceed, let's remember that the unit circle is basically a circle whose radius is equal to 1, and a circle that has the origin as its center. Remember that the origin is the point with coordinates 0 and 0. Remember also that using the unit circle to find the trigonometric ratios of an angle theta, all I have to do is draw the angle and then find the coordinates of the point at which the second side of the angle drawn intersects the unit circle. Let's call this point, this endpoint M. The coordinates of this point will basically show us the cosine and the sine of the original angle theta. And more precisely, the x coordinate will be equal to the cosine of this angle theta, while the y coordinate will be the sine of the angle theta, respectively. Having that in mind, we are ready to start finding the trigonometric ratios of 180 degrees. As mentioned before, I will begin by drawing an angle that measures 180 degrees. Remember that an angle consists of a vertex, which in our case will be the origin, and two sides. Always, when we use the unit circle, the first side will lie on the positive direction of the horizontal axis. So, for instance, if we could have named the first side, we would say that it is the segment OA. Then, moving in an anticlockwise manner, which is the positive way of creating angles, we will go up until we find an angle of 180 degrees. From there, we will see where the second side of this angle drawn intersects the unit circle. Let's name this point with M. The coordinates of this point will obviously be minus 1, 0. Its x coordinate will be negative 1, while its y coordinate will be 0. And that's how we will calculate the sine and the cosine. More precisely, as I have already stated before, the x coordinate will be the cosine of 180 degrees, while the y coordinate will be the sine. Therefore, cosine of 180 is equal to negative 1, while sine of 180 equals 0. Let's follow the same process to estimate the trigonometric ratios of 270 degrees. Again, as you can see in the diagram we have in front of us, we begin by drawing an angle of 270 degrees. Then we continue by spotting the point, let's call it M, at which the second side of this drawn angle intersects the unit circle. All we have to do now is estimate the coordinates of this point M. It is evident from the graph in front of us that M will have as its coordinates 0 and negative 1. And finally, remember that using these coordinates, we can easily calculate the trigonometric ratios of this drawn angle. More precisely again, the x coordinate of that point will be the cosine of the angle, so cosine of 270 is equal to 0, while on the other hand, the y coordinate of this point will be the sine of the drawn angle. And therefore, the sine of 270 degrees will be equal to negative 1. And that is all about this video. So basically, we learned a way by using the unit circle of knowing the trigonometric ratios of two more angles, of the angles that measure 180 and 270 degrees. If you face any difficulties about the content that was just mentioned, or for any kind of questions, you can always leave comments down below the video. As always, thank you for your time.